All right, so living behind the curtain of the web as you do, and seeing all the things that you see, and sort of seeing all the security challenges people are facing on a daily basis, what are some of the things that you personally avoid online and or avoid doing online? And on the flip side of that, what are some of the things that you do to protect your data on a daily basis that we could all learn from?
One, I never log in to any personal accounts on a shared computer. So like, I will never log in on like a hotel shared computer or, I don't know, computer in an airport. And I don't even log in to kind of like family and friends computers, just because like, I don't know what software is running on that, especially if it's a public computer. It's probably got malware and keyloggers and all types of digital germs. I also think in general, you know, just because I do see a lot of successful attacks and fraud and spam and criminal activity, I'm always just a little bit alert and suspicious, especially if something is asking me to share personal information or install something. If it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. So, you know, if in doubt, sometimes I'll ask a friend for a sanity check, because, you know, there's definitely a lot of malicious intent and attackers out there. In terms of things I do, one, try to always keep my software up to date. You know, a lot of updates include security fixes. And so ideally, you know, I'm using software that automatically updates. One of the things we built into Chrome is just it automatically updates, so you don't have to think about it. And that's really important, because out of date software is exploitable, and attackers are gonna, you know, try to break in via those unpatched security bugs. And then the other thing I do is just invest in making sure I have strong account security and account recovery options. So some services will ping you every year to kind of make sure, like, hey, do you still have access to this phone number or, you know, this backup email address? It's super important that those are up to date and secure, because hackers will try to break into your account via account recovery. So check account recovery, and then also use multiple factors of authentication. So that can be using like an SMS or a security code generator, because that just strengthens the account security, so that if you're using a weak password, you know, this is another layer of defense on that. So those are some things I avoid and try to do.
Great.